Good morning and welcome to today's International Space Station Update Hour. You're joining us here in the flight control room in Houston, Texas, where flight controllers are monitoring all the systems on board the orbiting laboratory as they control it orbiting just about 250 miles over the Earth's surface. Today, right now, the Orbit 2 team is currently on console and they're being led by Flight Director Gary Horlocker there in the center. And at the Capcom console, you can see astronaut Dan Tanney there. And joining him throughout the hour will be fellow NASA astronaut Katie Coleman. They will be serving as the voice links between the controllers here on the ground and the astronauts up in space. And those astronauts right now are the crew of Expedition 31, starting with our three astronauts who have been on board the station since last December. On the right, you have on the far right, NASA astronaut Don Pettit. Then in the front row, Expedition 31 commander Oleg Kononenko from the Russian Space Agency. And to his left is European Space Agency astronaut Andrei KUIPERS. And then to the left of him are our three station residents who just docked a few weeks back on May 16th, bringing the station back up to a full six-man rotation. And those three, starting on the far left, is NASA astronaut Joe ACABA on his second spaceflight. In the front row, veteran Russian cosmonaut CENNADY PADALKA, who is on his fourth and will be commanding Expedition 32 following the departure of Pettit, Kononenko, and KUIPERS. And then finally, in the back middle, Sergei REVIN, a third Russian cosmonaut on his first flight. The crew began their day today, waking up at about 1 a.m. Central Time, getting involved right off the bat in a number of experiments. Over on the Russian side, Commander Kononenko has been replacing a few of the components in the Russian toilet system today. He's also going to be participating in the Russian bar experiment, which looks to develop different methods for detecting any rapid depressurization in station modules. He'll also be doing some preparation work for his upcoming departure from the International Space Station when he undocks alongside with KUIPERS and Pettit on July 1st. Meanwhile, CENNADY PADALKA has been steeped in experiment work today, working with the plasma crystal, which is a study that looks at the growth of different plasma dust structures in zero gravity. He's also working with the Constanta experiment, which is one of the biological research projects over on the Russian side, which looks to study spaceflight factors like radiation and zero gravity and the effect that they have on different enzymes. Our third Russian cosmonaut, Sergei REVIN, was taking some photos for that plasma crystal experiment and also working on the bar experiment alongside Kononenko. He's also been involved in setting up the Russian Matryoshka experiment, named after the nested dolls that are fairly famous from Russia. It's a radiation research project that looks to study the different doses that the astronauts' bodies are subjected to during their long-duration space flights. Over on the U.S. segment, NASA astronaut Joe ACABA has been reviewing some procedures for his upcoming in-flight maintenance tasks of the thermal control system. Also doing some preparation work inside the Japanese experiment module, setting up the fluid system servicer's fluid control pump assembly. That's in advance of a coolant refill that he'll be doing a little bit later this week. And then throughout the hour today, he'll be working on the BAS experiment, which we'll be getting plenty of video down as he works with payload controllers in Cleveland. BAS standing for the Burning and Suppression of Solids. It's an investigation that looks to examine the burning and extinction characteristics of a wide variety of fuel samples in microgravity. Meanwhile, European astronaut Andrei KUIPERS is doing quite a few ultrasound scans today, working with the integrated cardiovascular, which he'll be doing some ultrasound scans of the heart muscle on both himself and Don Pettit, and also working with the vessel imaging experiment, which looks to study the different properties of blood vessel walls inside the astronaut and how they change over time. He also participated in a public affairs event with ESA and Euronews down on the ground. And then our final Expedition 31 crew member, NASA astronaut Don Pettit, has been working on the station's environmental health system, doing a removal and replacement of the total organic carbon analyzer. He'll also be packing up a few items for return on their Soyuz craft coming up in July. And as mentioned, he was working with that integrated cardiovascular, doing some ultrasound scans, alongside Andre Kuipers. Cool wrap up their day with the daily planning conference a few hours from now, and are scheduled to go to sleep at about 4:30 p.m. Central Time.